Hello, welcome. It's Ann Zuraw with Zuraw Financial Advisors, and today we're going to talk about divorce and the family business, and hoping this is working. So let's get started. We're going to talk about your exit strategy, and if you're partners, and a lot of you guys are entrepreneurs out there. Okay, good. We got one person joining, so I know it's working. And quick disclosure, I'm with Zuraw Financial Advisors. Thank you for the hearts. And I'm registered with the SEC, and no individual should assume that any information presented or made available through this video be construed as personalized financial planning or investment advice. So, all right, we're good. So, what is it? What it is? Okay. We're talking today about going into business and exiting your business. So, in the situation with the divorce, a lot of people I know have their own businesses and they've been working, potentially working together or benefiting from the family business ownership. And just talking about if you're thinking, if you have your own business and your spouse or partner works with you, just to really think about the exit strategy and what you could do today to exit the business from each other without everything falling apart. And just to give you a little bit about my background, I'm with Zuraw Financial Advisors, but I was part of a family business for 25 years and had the actually, it was a gift that there were 11 grandchildren in my generation that were all shareholders in the business, and there were three brothers that were the owners, and a lot of the interest in the company went to our generation. And so as a result, we were all involved in the business. And so I saw how live the family business and how it transitioned over those 25 years, and we sold the majority of it in 2007. So, but again, we all learned as we went, and there were a lot of different issues about dealing with spouses and dealing, we had divorce and ownership and succession planning, and these are all issues when you're going into business together, no matter the size of the business. And it may be starting out in your home office and you're a blogger, but you're still running a business and your spouse or partner may be helping you. And are you recognizing that? And if you do split up, what that would mean. So I just thought I'd go over some of the issues that you might consider ahead of time or during the process if you already have a business with a partner. And because these issues kind of never go away. So right when you get started, do you have a legal agreement? Have you set it up as an official company? That's important just for liability, for ongoing. And if your partner is working for you or with you, do they have ownership or not? And really laying out the groundwork. So having a legal document, whether you're married or not, you're still a business partner. Having a non-compete potentially, if you're, you know, both decide to go on your own because you've developed this business. Having life insurance would be great because if you have life insurance and you have a cash value, you could use that potentially to buy each other out. And is there a succession plan? I don't speak English. Okay, sorry. Well, we're talking about family business and I don't speak Russian. So I guess you might want to go to another Periscope where they're speaking Russian. But so in your family business, you've got, consider succession planning, because I think the great thing about succession planning is if you get hit by a bus, what happens to the business? And that actually makes you realize that and recognize the strength of what your partner is bringing to the business and how they could handle it in the future. So that is a great exercise again, and I've gone through that personally and realize how, you know, my husband is helping me even though he's not officially part of my business at all. But he is somebody I do talk to about it, and I value his input. So, you know, to what extent is that really part of the business or not? So that's one issue. And then do you have a board? Do you have any outside people involved? Because I think that's another, everyone always says have a board of advisors, have other people involved, and that really helps in negotiating with your partner or having it be much more professional. So that's the other thing, is just because you're married or a partnership doesn't mean you shouldn't have a professional arrangement and the legal documents or have a succession plan or the board. I think a lot of people may don't do things because it's a family business or they don't want to offend their partner, and that's actually not a reason to do it. It's better for everyone to go ahead and document it. So I'll just repeat, I'm Ann Zuraw with Zuraw Financial Advisors. I'm a certified financial planner, a certified financial divorce analyst, and I thought we'd just start talking about dealing with your business as an entrepreneur, and if you're married to your someone who is actually working with you in the business, how you deal with that. And I always, one of our mantra is plan for the unexpected. So plan for things not going well, whether somebody decides they no longer want to work for the business, or you get divorced, or they want to cash out. And having those documents and infrastructure in place to allow that, so that you're not completely tied to each other for the rest of your life in this business. And if you decide to get divorced, it would be all in place. So again, recognizing the value that each other are bringing, because I think a lot of times one person may be, I've seen people that a doctor and the wife is doing the bookkeeping, but the doctor is his practice, but yet she's doing the bookkeeping. And so what is that other person providing for the business? And that's where the succession planning does come into play, because if you get hit by the bus and you realize that person is instrumental to keeping the business going, then you really need to acknowledge their contribution and ownership. And that's, in the case of divorce, that would be also the situation. So clear defining about what each other's role is important. I would encourage one person not to be the financial person and the other person be the creative, to really understand what each other are providing, understand what the other are doing, especially with the finances, because sometimes people assume the finances are being handled correctly and they're not. And that's actually everybody's responsibility. So it's both your responsibilities to understand, and that will help hold you in good stead. That's where I also encourage having a third party or the advisors involved, because then you have more objective, somebody else to hold you accountable, and they actually could be kind of a mediator / more reasonable, you know, because again, when you're starting a business or you've got a business that's going, it's hard to navigate, and the more infrastructure you have in place, the better everybody is in managing. So we talked about having an insurance policy on each other. That's another way to go. If one person wants to exit, that you might have cash value. We talked about a non-compete. That's a legal agreement, so that if they decide to leave and you've built up this business, they don't just replicate it and copy it and you have nothing and you're now competing against one of your partners. And if you have kids, that's actually another issue, that you want your kids to benefit from the business. And I always encourage to get your kids involved in family businesses. I know that everybody has different views about that one, and I respect them, but as someone that benefited from a family business and with my generation being involved, it really was a gift and a wonderful experience, and I do recommend it, and it actually means that's a great succession plan for the family business. So this is just a short, thinking about the family business and the partnership and an exit strategy. Whenever you go into business together, it's important to have that exit strategy. And unfortunately, when divorced, you're using the exit strategy. But even if you're not getting divorced, it's good to have plan B, and just in case things aren't going well, so that everybody has the option to kind of go on with their lives. So I'm Ann Zuraw with Zuraw Financial Advisors in Greensboro, North Carolina. It's a beautiful day here, and I just want to encourage you to really think out partnerships and you entrepreneurs out there. How would you exit from your business, from your partner / spouse, and recognizing the value each person is bringing to the party. So thank you all for listening. Everybody have a great day, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.